sun, I might have known. If God granted me his son, the summer's die one by one. How soon they fly on and on. And I am born and will be gone. Bring him peace, bring him joy. He is young, he's only a boy, and you can tell. Let him be, let him live. If I die, let me die, let him live.
Welcome to Backstage. I am delighted to be with you here. My name is Mark Forrest. I am an Irish tenor. In fact, it could be said that I'm the fourth Irish tenor that no one knows anything about. But I'm here today to change that. And I'd like to let you know a small bit about my music, my family, and what we're trying to do in the future. When I came to the United States in 1990, I was afforded an opportunity. Our second child was John Patrick. John Patrick was born with a metabolic disorder. My son, John Patrick, is blind and deaf and today is confined to a wheelchair. It changed my life forever. It was then I really began to understand the importance of living the present moment in one's life. Both I and my wife fought very hard for 2 years to keep our son alive. John has become the greatest blessing in our life. And for those of you who are listening today, who have a special needs child, I dedicate this very special song to you. This song is called Scorn Not His Simplicity.
See the child with the golden hair, eyes show the emptiness inside. Do we know? Can we understand just how he feels? Or have we really tried? See him now. As he sits alone, watches children play at children's games. A simple child, he looks almost like the others, and yet they know he's not the same. Scorn not his simplicity. Rather try to love him all the more. Scorn not his simplicity, oh no. Oh no. see him stare, not recognizing the kind face that only yesterday he loved. The loving voice of a mother who can't understand what she's been guilty of. And how she cried tears of happiness the day the doctor told her it's a boy. And now she cries tears of helplessness and thinks of all the things he can't enjoy. Scorn not his simplicity, rather try to love him all the more. Scorn not his simplicity, oh no. Oh no. Only he knows how to face the future, hopefully, yet surrounded by despair. But he won't ask for your pity or your sympathy, but surely you should care. Scorn his simplicity, rather try to love him all the more. Scorn not his simplicity, oh no.
Scorn not his simplicity. For those of us who have been blessed with the gift of a special needs child, and for all of us who know of a special needs child,
Denny boy, the pipes, pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone. When summer's in When you come, and all the flowers are dying, if I am dead, dead I will maybe, you'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an Ave there for me, and I shall hear those soft you tread upon.
Well, that is, of course, the great song, Danny Boy. And after losing Francesco, my son, and after bringing Christ into the equation, God blessed both my wife and I. He gave us three healthy children right after Francesco. So I invite those of you who have lost someone, and those of you who struggle with the daily routine of your special needs child, to bring Christ into that equation. Because with every cross God gives us, He gives us the grace to see that cross through. And more often than not, we spend so much time complaining about the cross, we forget to ask Him for the graces that come alongside with the cross. In 1999, my wife and I set up a foundation called Faith and Family Foundation, which is a committed effort on our behalf to support fellow parents with disabilities. It's a support mechanism, but there's one thing that we try to do is to bring in the spiritual dimension and understanding that Christ wants to carry that cross with you. Within my travels in music, I have learned that if you ever want to hear God laugh, tell Him your plans in life. More often than not, what we expect out of life is not what God wants us to do. We have all got to find our road. We all have to find our own personal journey with Christ. And when we find that journey, we've got to bring Christ every day with us. Thank you for taking this time out of your busy lives to spend it with me, Mark Forrest. May all of us take a more serious commitment by inviting Christ into our lives, so that all of our dreams will be made possible much more efficiently with Christ being with us.
To dream the impossible dream, unbeatable foe, to bear unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to rise. unrightable wrong. To love, pure and chaste from afar. To try, when your arms are too weary. To reach the unreachable star. This is my quest. Question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know we will always be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm. Better for this, that one man scorned and covered in scars still strove with one last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable
peccatoribus, ora pro nobis. Great show, everyone.